So this compare and swap instruction is going to return true if it found that L and me, the first two arguments, were the same, and therefore it set L to the third argument. In that case, it's a success, and success is indicated by a true being returned by this operation. But on the other hand, if the comparison failed, it won't do the swap. It'll simply return false. So it won't do the swap, but it'll return false. So that's the semantic of this particular instruction. Again, this is an atomic instruction, and this atomic instruction may be available in the architecture, but if it isn't, then you have to simulate it using test and set instruction. So in this particular example that I'm showing you, when I try to do this unlock operation, because this new guy has come in and he's executing, is halfway through executing his lock algorithm. So he's done the fetch and store, and he's going to set up the list so that my next pointer will point to him. So that's the process that he is in right now. So at that point, I'm coming in and I'm saying, well, I want to do the unlock operation. And that's when I found that my next pointer is nil. And so what I have to do is do this compare and swap. And at the compare and swap, now it's going to return to me false, indicating that this particular operation failed. So once I know that this operation has failed, then I'm going to spin. And so the semantic of the unlock call is I come in, remove myself from L. And in order to do that, I'm going to do this compare and swap on the linked list. And if I find that the compare and swap instruction fails, I'm going to spin. Now, what am I spinning on? When will it become not nil? So basically, what I'm going to do is I'm going to spin on my next pointer being not nil. So right now, it's nil. That's the reason that I think that there's nobody after me. I was going to set this guy to nil. But I know the compare and swap fail, and therefore, I know that there's a request and formation, and I'm going to spin waiting for my next pointer to become not nil. Now, when will my next pointer become not nil? Remember that this guy, the new guy, that is doing this lock operation, doing exactly what I did earlier, right? And what he's doing is he's gotten my coordinates, and he's in the process of setting it up so that my next pointer is going to point to him. So eventually, he'll complete that operation. So my spinning is on this becoming not nil, and it'll become not nil because of this new guy completing what he needs to do as part of this lock operation. And so eventually, the next pointer in my node will point to him. And at that point, I can come out of my spin loop. Now I'm ready to signal the successor that, hey, you got the lock. So that's how I can make sure that when we unlock the corner case that occurs during unlock, and that is there is no requesters after me, I can take care of that by doing this atomic operation and ensuring that there is no race condition between me, the unlocker, and a new requester that is in the process of forming through this lock call. So once this lock data structure has been fixed up nicely by this new requester, so far as I'm concerned, everything is good. The list is good, and therefore I can go ahead and signal the next guy that he's got the lock and be done with it.